I was looking for just a way to challenge myself and have fun, and I always wanted to take a dance class, but I was nervous, and in the past, the dance classes I had tried were pretty intimidating, and I ended up, not returning. So, but I recommitted to the notion of taking a dance class, and, I went to Kristen's class, Yoga Booty Ballet, and it was incredible. It really reassured me that, taking risks like that and pushing myself just a lot past my comfort zone. Usually I pride myself on being really serious, and, going in there and just being goofy is pretty fun. And, the non-judgmental quality of the class has been really great.
Before I found Kristen's class, I had for a long time really wanted to take a dance class. Like, this was a thing that I had in my mind of something that I wanted to do. I wanted to take a dance class. But I was really petrified because I'm not a dancer. I never took dance classes as a child. And I found her class, and I tried some other ones, and I was petrified. But she has this amazing ability to kind of make it playful and not judgmental, and you kind of just let go, which is, I don't do that a lot in other parts of my life, I don't think. Yoga Booty Ballet is a hybrid of yoga, fun, lighthearted cardio dance, and the fundamentals of ballet. Before we do anything, there's time to check in, and to check in with your head, your heart, and your body, and to set an intention. And the setting of an intention really brings all of your energy inward. And we all need that. We all need just a moment to check in with ourselves, to see what's going on. And that awareness is invaluable. I was doing laundry at a laundromat in West Hollywood and heard Madonna blaring out of the doors of Swerve. And I looked up and I saw a bunch of chicks jumping around, and I thought, I need to do more of that.
Inhale through your nose. Through your mouth, exhale. And rub your hands together. We're generating tapas, which is burning desire, psychic heat. It's focused, positive energy.
Gillian was teaching the first class I ever took. And I remember going up into a particular move called the sunflower. And as I came down, I just breathed like the deepest breath that I had in a long time. So that feeling of the deep breath, and that feeling of your breeze, feeling your breeze, like you're in your element, like you're where you're supposed to be. And everything that's going on for you is okay. That's the feeling that is important to me. That's the feeling that I hope to share with anybody. Starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out, and I'll lay your ship bare. See, I'll leave with every piece of you. Don't underestimate the things that I will do. There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. The scars of your whatever you do with your girlfriends in the living room,
with the stereo turned up as loud as it can go. That's what I want. And that's what I try to do. There's a lot of hype around enlightenment and what that is. And I personally kind of believe a little rock and roll can help get you there. There's something to be said for moving to, you know, no matter what you've got going on that day, showing up, feeling a beat, letting it move through you, and just moving. And that it's not about what your body looks like, it's about having a great time with yourself. It's about having an experience with yourself. It's about giving yourself an opportunity to celebrate. I like to encourage people to let go of judgment. Letting go of judgment they have on themselves, on their body, and of anyone else in the room. And when you can create that space is very important. It's sacred. This whole thing is so magnetic that it started off with me just wanting to be there, me just wanting to dance, and it's amazing how many people have come to join me who just want to dance too. And I think everybody wants to dance in some way, and everybody can.